half of the dark side. And for what it's worth, that was a very common term that you'll hear me refer to Brent as senior, because there was senior and there was junior. I'll tell you a little story, or actually a fairly long story. In 1980, I came to Yuma with the United States Marine Corps as a young charger Marine. And I get here, ready to go, ready to take on the world, and I say, man, it would be nice to have a car. And everyone says, hey, you know, there's this dealership on Orange Avenue. They give you some pretty good deals when I talk to the guy there. He takes care of the Marines. He likes the Marines. So I go down to Orange, I go to his place, and I'm talking to one of the sales guys, and Singer comes up. He says, hey, you know, what are you looking for here? I say, you know, I really like this Mustang, but boy, this price, it's just, you know, I can't afford it. I'm a young Marine, only been in the Corps less than a year. He says, hey, listen, there's something about you. I tell you what, come down on the weekends when you have some time and help me square away this place, you know. I'll put you to work in a little work something out. And so, thus my introduction to being around senior and basically junior. But I go into this place and there's junk everywhere. There's boats and cars and crap all over the place. And it says, I want you to help organize and get this thing straight. And don't worry about the car. Don't worry about the price. As a matter of fact, take the car. I'm like, I haven't paid you anything. You don't know me. He goes, hey, I trust you. You're a Marine. Over time, I think like a couple of weeks later, I get to meet Junior, this cocky, arrogant kid. He's on top of the world. He's like, who are you? I'm like, hey, you know, I'm doing some stuff with your dad here. Well, over time, we would run around and do all the types of things. And Senior would literally treat us both like his boys. And, you know, I remember going to auction in Phoenix on his plane, which I was like, wow, we get to run it on a plane. And one of the individuals at the auction said, well, who's this guy? He says, that's my son. And the guy looks at me, looks at Senior, and Senior says, he looks a lot like his mom. From that point on, I developed this relationship with Senior, and I tell you, he introduced me into an entirely different world. He said, look, I'm going to make you to your max potential. And he would sit with me and sit with Junior, and he would show me coins, and he'd say, this is called a Rolex. You know, and he'd lay stuff out and say, you know, this is how you play golf. And we'd go out and practice swings and practice drives. And again, back to the plane, you know, we would take all these various trips. And then, of course, at the time, Junior got his trip. But I'll share a real quick story about Junior, as he talks about Senior being terrified. As we were flying there one time, because Junior's big thing was, hey, let's fly to San Diego for lunch. You know, let's take off here. But one time we're flying into Vegas, and we get a side wind, and the plane's going sideways. And Junior wasn't so tough on that day. Didn't want to tell all those great stories, but he panicked a little bit too. But I will tell you this. You know, I did my time in the Marine Corps, and it was coming to an end after my first enlistment. I said, you know, I'm looking at getting out. And he said, what are you going to do? Think it through. You know, plan your future, plan what you're going to do. And I tell you, Seal was one for wise counsel. Anytime I returned back to Yuma, he said, make sure you got your butt here. After my first enlistment, fighting in Somalia, going to Panama, Marine Corps said, where would you like to go there, Marine? I said, you know what, I want to go to Yuma, Arizona. They were like, you're kidding. Hey, no problem, you're going. As a matter of fact, Mr. Mondragon there actually served with me and within my command, but I was back in Yuma again, and this time, Senior said, you're coming to work for me at Yuma Air Force. In a joint partnership with Gary Pierce. And over time, you're going to work with me at Country Club Honda. And when the Marine Corps sent me other places, Senior said, hey, look, you are always part of this family. You are my dog son. And I remember the baseball player, God, what was his name? the big arm, Steve Garber. Steve Garber comes out, we go to this big dinner, and Senior tells him, hey, my son will be here shortly, and I know this from Mr. Garber, because they come up and sit, and he goes, hey, like, that's for Brett Damon's son. my junior and Nick were out of town, and I said, yeah, that's me. He began looks, and I said, it's my mom. Senior comes down, puts his arm around me, and say, you ever met my son? So it was always a running communication that this is the dark son. And even when we go out and eat, and they would say, Senior would say, this is my son, Laura Sanders. She would say, it was a wild time, you know. Or she would say, wait a second, I'm not that old, you know. But I will say, you know, the enhancement of my life as a young man coming from Chicago, projects of Chicago, you know, I was introduced to what gold is, what silver is, how to play golf, how to water ski, and being out on the water, how to snow ski, what it is, what vehicles are in the business, acumen and sense of how to do things correct and right. Senior would sit with me for hours and say, make sure you know the deal, how to close the deal, how to work the deal, but enjoy life to the maximum. And to extend it to your kids. My kids would come around and see him say, you know, refer to me as grandpa. So he'll be highly missed. But as Junior says, one day we'll see him again. So I'll make mine short. I'll hand it back over to you.